Good afternoon, everyone. I'm your host today, Sean, from Huaihai Holding Group. Today, I'm going to tell you a story first. 40 years ago, when China is in the age of one of its greatest transformations and revolutions of all time, Huaihai, formerly known as the Xuzhou Tricycle Manufacturing, was set up from the ground up. At that time, there were very few ways for people for cargo carrying. The most popular way is to ride a tricycle, as tricycle is commonly affordable among common people when carrying goods. Our sales went very well in the 1980s. As time went by, the economy of China in the 1990s began to grow at fast pace. Ways of transportation came into being. Cars, trucks, motorcycles began to appear on the road more and more often. And innovations bloomed in the land of China everywhere. Then changes also came on us to compete with new innovations and transportations. We used motors to replace manpower in our products. As in such a way, people carry more rounds of goods in the same time with faster speed and less of energy. So our products went remarkable achievement again in the market in China. Coming into the new century, China started to accelerate in the economy and became the second economy in the whole world. So did Huaihai. And innovation and integration between motorcycles and tricycle appeared at this very moment. Together with Zongshen Motors, we have created the very first motor tricycle here in the whole world at this very place. And Jiangsu Zongshen was born at that same time. From then on till now, the popularization of motor tricycle became unstoppable from China to the rest of the world. Undoubtedly, we have become the largest tricycle manufacturer in the whole world from that day on till now for 15 consecutive years. Now Huaihai Holding Group has become a multinational enterprise with the producing of small vehicles from tricycles, motor tricycles, electric tricycles, scooters, and to EV cars. Today, our protagonist that I want to introduce to you is the very model that leads our enterprise to a higher level and world fame. It is the most common and simple model that we see everywhere in the world, the cargo tricycle. This is one of the top sales model that we sell in the world. It is one of the most economical products that we have for foreign markets. So now today, let's find out the reason why it becomes the superstar. Let's start from the front. Here we have equipped this model with a large front lamp, which makes sure it is able to run in low visibility, such as nighttime, rainy days, sandy weather, with good vision. Also, the turning indicators are shiny enough to warn people on the road when turning into other directions. And on the back, there are a light panel here. There's a light panel here with braking, turning, and a reversing sign. Also, we have equipped the reversing warning in different languages when a tricycle isn't in the process of reversing. And here is the horn, which is very, very clear and strong. And these two beams we design here is to protect the driver when there is a collision from the front. All these equipments and designs are meant to guarantee the safety of the driver. And talking about driving, comfort is another important factor that affects the driving experience. In order to make as comfortable as possible, we have made three major improvements. So the first one is the front absorber. And the second one, we may need some help here. We need to lift up. The second one is the rear suspension. Here, the rear suspension. And the third one is the improvements of the cushion. So let's go with the first one, the front absorber. We have here a hydraulic absorber, which is among the best of all means to absorb the shock during driving. And we reinforce this absorber with this outer spring around. Its diameter is 50 millimeter, which is strong enough for all kinds of road conditions. And next, let's check the rear suspension. We equip this model with 5 pieces leaf spring. The spring is made of special synthetic material, which is both strong and elastic. In total, 5 pieces guarantee the intensity to support the whole vehicle. And also we have improved the material of the cushion. It is elastic and soft, but not easy to be transformed after a long time of driving. Next, we are going to talk about the power. Power is the very reason why everything moves. For tricycles, the engine is the heart of it, which provides the force to drive the vehicle. For every motor tricycle, we use engine from Zongshen Motors, which is the best engine designed for tricycle in the world. Many foreign markets accept only the Zongshen brand. For this model, we use 150 cc air cooling 4-stroke engine. Its power is strong enough to carry a weight of more than 1,000 kilograms ideally. The engine is mostly used in West Africa and Southeast Asia, where the climate is for the most of time very hot. To adapt such climates, experts from Honda Japan were invited to make more than 60 improvements till now. In such way, could be able to make sure that every end customer drives at full speed without worry. Also, we have equipped here with an 18-liter fuel tank. Ideally, this model could run more than 450 kilometers with this fuel tank. And for carrying goods, we have a cargo box here, which is the length is 180 centimeters, the width is 125, and the height is 34. It is big enough for common use with goods weighing more than 600 kilograms. And we also strengthened the box with this solid bar on the outside. Okay, for talking about the wheels here, and the front and rear wheels are all the same size, so they are interchangeable. And we also equipped here inside with a spare tire on the bottom of the cargo box here. And when there is any of the tires broken, people could change easily with the tools we give freely on every tricycle. Another important part of the tricycle is the rear axle, which transmits the power onto the wheel. On this model, we use the floating rear axle, the working mechanism of which is the same on trucks. The thickness of the axle tube is larger, and the floating mechanism makes sure that the axle won't break in extreme conditions. With better resistance and steadiness, The rear axle provides both good transmission effect and most of all, safety. And for the braking system, we use the mechanical braking with drums on front and rear wheels. It makes sure that the vehicle could be stopped any minute it needs to. Okay, after the brief introduction, you guys may have a brief idea of the tricycle. And today we have the honor to invite one of our engineers. He is one of the most experienced engineers in our group. He has created many models in our company and also this one. Let's welcome Mr. Chen. He will explain more in more professional ways, and he will first explain in Chinese and I will help to translate. Welcome.
观看直播的各位朋友大家好，作为跨骑车是这种燃油货运三轮车当中最传统最常见的车型，今天我们就和大家聊一聊我们是如何实现整车的经济性和悬挂的这种耐久性的。
Today we will talk about how we realize the economy and the carrying capability of a tricycle.
如果说把一辆车比作一个人的话，那么动力系统就相当于是人的心脏，而悬挂系统就相当于人的骨骼，这两项非常重要。If
we compare a tricycle as a man, the engine system is like the heart, and suspension is like bones, which are both very important.
在动力选择上，我们首先为客户定制一套合理的方案。 我们结合客户当地的路况、气候以及使用场景。
We will consider the road conditions, climate, and all kinds of using situations to calculate and choose the options for our customers in terms of economy and motoring.
计算出一整套的合理的配置方案，我们的车型因地制宜，而不是千篇一律。
We will calculate all the specifications according to these conditions. We do not duplicate, but every model differs according to different situations.
那么我们的动力系统从细处着手，我们的发动机是燃油货运车型专用的状态。 经过市场大量长期的验证，
We have witnessed a lot of situations on the market, so we start our design from these according to these experience.
我们的发动机有几大特点，第一个，我们的比如说我们发动机的加大油底壳。 钢头螺栓的加强，还有主副齿轮的加强，以及静音钢头的使用，都极大的提升了发动机的寿命。
We have a few characteristics and improvements on the engines. We have enlarged the fuel pan, strengthened the cylinder head bolts, strengthened the gear teeth, and we have a mute cylinder head to improve and enlarge the lifetime of the engine.
我们的进排气系统经过了多轮的这种优化升级，像化油器是精准调教过，而空气滤清器是属于两次过滤系统，而排气相生器是联合国内一流的研究所共同研制的这种优良产品。
We have multiple upgrades in the exhaust system. We have adjusted the carburetor, and we have two-time air filter, and we have also equipped the exhaust silencer, which are accords with the norm of the United Nations.
正是由于系统性的优化。 所以我们的发动机有一个良好的功率曲线和一个较低的燃油效果值。
With such methods, our engine has very high efficiency and very low fuel consumption.
那么前后悬挂系统呢？同样的，我们也是一个，首先还是一个合理的配置。
For the front and rear suspension system, we have very reasonable options.
我们对悬挂系统的刚度与强度形成的匹配、耐热及冷却性能，还有动挠度和静挠度的测试及升级数据的分析和测量，形成了一套我们自己特有的前后悬挂系统的参数系统。
We have formed our own front and rear suspension system with the calculation and analysis of intensity, distribution of stroke, heat resistance, and cooling performance.
从细的上讲，我们的前叉，我们对前叉的平行度、光柄杆的光洁度都有严格的检测规范。
In details, we have very strict demand for the parallelism of front fork and the cleanliness of such fork.
我们的前叉每次的检测都在10万次以上的耐久试验。
We have endurance tests for more than 100,000 times.
我们前叉的油封锁定的是国内的一流供应厂家。
And we have the first class supplier for our front fork.
我们前叉的上脸板是重力铸造，并经过了 T6 时效处理。
For the front, we have a fixed direction column with double bolts. Yes.
我们的下脸板的方向柱是采用的双螺母锁定，解决了市面上长期使用螺母松动的问题。
With such method, we have solved the long problem of unsteadiness of the bolts.
那么我们再看一下我们的后悬挂系统。我们的板簧是一个5片，宽度为63毫米的便捷面板簧，它的材质是60硅尔锰。
For the rear suspension, we have used a very special material, with the width of 63 millimeters and 5 pieces a leaf spring.
钢板弹簧具备了合理的行程及满载的弧高，它的结构极为简约，而且载重性能非常强。
In such a way, we have simpler structure, with good loading capacity.
我们单架板簧的这种极限承载能够达到1.8吨左右。
The one single spring, a leaf, could carry of more than 1.5 tons.
我们的钢板弹簧完全按照汽车钢板弹簧标准，耐久试验10万次以上。
We have the endurance tests of more than 100,000 times, according to the norm, in the car production.
整车前后悬挂的合理匹配，使我们整车平顺性强，耐久性好。
In such a way, we have better endurance and the performance.
另外，后桥作为我们整车的关重零部件，我们的后桥，桥壳为60×4规格的。
And as another important component, the rear axle, the shell is 60 multiply 3.5.
左右半轴都是中频调制。
The left and right axle have been specialized treated.
那么内部的花件呢是高频调制淬火。
The other component which is within this rear axle is also been specially treated.
主检的从动齿和主动齿都是加强型，经过多轮的优化。
The differential has been strengthened in both ways.
我们车的自动鼓是为 180毫米 自动鼓。
The brake drum in the rear axle is with the diameter of 180 millimeters.
保障了整车的制动能力。
It ensures the braking capability of the vehicle.
并且我们整车也经过多轮的自动性能的调校，使我们的整车空车比较轻盈，而整车载重的情况下无任何带刹的情况。
And with this, with a lot of improvements and adjustments of the braking system, the effect tends to be more light with no side effect.
好，我的介绍就到这里，谢谢大家。
This is the end of my conversation. Thank you. Thank you very much. Mr. Chen really taught us more in the more professional views. And after the introduction of this product, here we have a few questions from the online guests. Now we have three questions here. The first one is, they want to know where is the location of our headquarter. Last time I have explained this question, I wanted to repeat again. Our headquarter is in the city of Xuzhou, in the north part of Jiangsu Province. If you take by high railway train, it takes less than 3 hours from either Shanghai or Beijing. And if you get to the railway station, it takes only 5 minutes by driving. If you want to come and visit us by flight, the airport is 1 hour driving away. Of course, we will pick you up. And around our headquarter, there are plenty of hotels and restaurants of all styles. So don't worry about the accommodation if you arrive and visit us. The second question is that some of our guests never heard about the city of Xuzhou. So as I was born here, I have the honor to introduce the city here. Xuzhou is very important and historical city in China. It has a history of 4,000 years. Due to its important geographic situation and position, it has become the capital of many kingdoms in different ages. So if you come, it is inevitable to learn some cultures here in Xuzhou. And we have plenty of museums, which is free for you to visit us. And now Xuzhou has become one of the most developed cities in China. As I have mentioned, the transportation system here is one of the most convenient in China. You could almost visit most of the places directly by train or flight from the city of Xuzhou. People gather to work and live here in this beautiful city. There are many small lakes, small hills, and free parks for people to enjoy themselves at any time, any area. Talking about the food, Xuzhou is very famous for his long history of cuisine. We have specialties from all kinds, from breakfast to supper, from cookies to meals. We are an open city, we have also restaurants of exotic cultures for foreign guests. So you could fully enjoy yourself while eating in Xuzhou. So the city of Xuzhou and its people are always warm and pleased to welcome all guests from all around. And the second question is about our company. They want to know, how did we go in the global markets? Till now, our business has reached more than 80 countries in the whole world. Our most important markets are in Africa, South America, South Asia, and most of the countries in these regions are developing countries. So people there tend to use our products to make a living by carrying goods and driving people. So our products almost became a necessity for their daily life. Now we have subsidiaries in in India, Pakistan, Peru, and Chile. And in the future, we plan to cut more directly into these markets and into our current and potential markets. That's all the answers about today's questions. And through today's broadcast, I hope you got to know more about our company and our products. If you have further questions about the company, the product, the city of Xuzhou, or about anything, just contact our assistant. They are 24 hours online and pleased to be at your service. I think that's pretty much about today's broadcast. If you want to know more, just follow us. So this is your host, Sean, today. See you tomorrow.